Hey guys, Corey here. I'm gonna try to do this video here a little different. I'm gonna actually wear the camera like you would wear a GoPro, but it's just to hold the iPhone. So anyway, got two rooms. I got one room sprayed, one room dry, and the stairs are dry. So we're gonna clean all of those. And it's a light carpet that's got, it's got some black smudges on it and stuff. So basically just a heavier than average pre-spray along with a lot of pre-spotting and ammonia before I began here. So that's already been done here. I had some red in there, some light red. When I hit it with ammonia, it just went away. Works really good. Anyway, let me go ahead and turn the camera around here and then put it on, and then we'll either produce some video everybody likes or just flat out hates. One or two, I don't know. It'll just be, I guess, watching the machine clean. Kind of like in the very beginning when I first started putting in videos. I'm just holding the camera and running the machine at the same time. So cleaned everywhere one-handed for about a year. All right, here we go. All right, there should be a little sway in the camera here and there. So I believe when I upgrade iPhones here, as soon as I decide what carrier I'm gonna use, I believe there's more image stabilization on the newer ones. The convenience of using iPhone is just amazing how you can do it all on just one device. Anyway, here we go. I'm gonna clean. Thank you. There we go, everybody's favorite. Piss off somebody somewhere when you grab the ammonia. I would love to know exactly how much time has been spent with guys trying to create something that will replace ammonia that they can charge more for. You know, the only reason why you don't have people selling you ammonia is because there's no patent on that anymore. It's you know, it's just like anything else. You know, it's just a basic cleaner that outcleans just basically about anything. You know, it's pungent. If you're not used to it, it'll burn your eyes, makes breathing a little difficult. But I'm here alone, and I don't mind. So it does me well. You know, I think I got the most negative feedback about ammonia, and it's, you know, all from people that sell cleaning chemicals that don't want you to know about ammonia because it's something you can buy for damn near nothing, just about anywhere. You saw me missed it with a 50-50 solution of ammonia and water and erase more soil. notice, if you clean with the larger machine, you can't do this. I've been cleaning for this client for, I don't know, he's one of the newer ones, probably about 7 or 8 years now. So that's a new client for me, 7 or 8 years, still a new client. Cleaned this place a handful of times. It's finally to the point to where it's just extremely, extremely worn. This area here was never going to stand up again. Just happy to make it look clean again. All right, we pre-sprayed into the hallway. And you see little spots like that right there. They got a shot of ammonia before I began. Give it a little longer to dwell. I'm gonna do this one. Clean this one and we'll come back and have a look. Gotta see if there's any text messages came through. All right, now I'm gonna try to groom like this. Amazing how much wear it has and how presentable it still looks. It is just beat up to no end. This is just a little higher quality that can take the abuse. Either that, or sometimes if they're clever, they'll go with a cheaper carpet and a heavier pad. That way, the reason why a carpet will last longer if it has a heavier pad under it is because it flexes less when you step on it. So if the carpet, if it's being held up really good from the bottom and it doesn't flex all that much when you step on it, it doesn't stretch it and start to work its way apart. So when you put the really cheap carpet on the really cheap pad, you got something that'll last 2 or 3 years. If you do the really cheap carpet on fairly expensive pad, you can save a little money like that and have it last a little longer if you are willing to clean it, you know, at least once a year, maybe twice, depending on, you know, pets, kids, foot traffic, all those things come into play. Kind of funky feeling working with a camera like this. All right, now we've got some stairs here we want to play with. So, let's see here. Probably ought to get that guy set up ahead of time, but there you go. Got the pad wet now. See? So we'll take a look at it when I'm done here. That is a pretty dirty spot right there. And right there, so we'll up that a little bit. you gotta put a fair amount of prep time into your cleaning before you actually run the machine across it. You gotta get all the soil ready to be removed. Amazing all the different people you meet when you run a small carpet cleaning business. Like right now, I'm gently concerned about, you know, the van being parked outside. I take a look every once in a while, make sure it's still out there. You know, and then, you know, I know the next client, I know where I'm going, but you know, there's times when you'll clean for, you know, someone that's so wealthy you can't even get your head around it. And then you'll be cleaning for somebody that's completely in a different place in their life. You know, like I've had days in the past where I'll start out. Remember one morning I cleaned for a guy that was on the state lottery commission. He was one of the 8 investigators. And then I think the very next house I went to was somebody selling weed out of the back door. You know, and they let me in, and they go back to doing what they're doing, and just amazing, you know. And it's something that you just learn to see after you've been at this for so long. You know, people will say things to you can't believe they said, and then sometimes you'll hear something that's so incredibly kind you'll want to cry. So you never know who you're gonna meet when you're running a small business. See if I can hop off the steps with it. No glider on the steps. keep hitting the button with my belt loop. I mean, with my belt buckle. So that's why I've seen it stop a couple times almost. I've got two orbiters. I've got this one I use most of the time because it's got the on-off switch here, and I've got another one that it's got it down here somewhere, so I have to turn it on and off with my foot, so I prefer this one. Plus, it's all, it used to be shiny and white, now it's dirty and white, but still, the only time I usually use it is when I do the stairs and sometimes on delicate rugs where I want to run a little bit lighter on it. You know, different size machines, different... Use different size machines, different chemicals, different towels, different gliders. You learn how to put it all together to do what you're doing, you know. And it's not something that, you know, that I could just instruct you to do. It's something that it takes experience, you know, and it's experience something you have to gain yourself through trial and error. So you go to someone's house and you're cleaning, and then where you learn is when it gets really difficult. Is when you learn. If everything's going smoothly, you don't learn anything. But when you got something that won't come out of the carpet, you know, that's where you learn. You know, I'll get text messages from people, you know, about that. And I'll ask them, what do you have on hand? You know, maybe I can help you select something better to, you know, to get that out with. And I've helped a lot of people like that, you know. So anyway, got one more step to go here, and then I'm going to go wipe all of these boards off down here. Because that is the one thing that you leave behind. It'll dig up stuff out of the carpet and it'll throw it along the boards, baseboards. To see, not a ton to learn here today, but content. Not gonna put any footprints on that or on that. pH was fairly high and peroxide was fairly high, but nothing was through the roof. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Happy New Year. If you have questions, you can put them in the comments and I'll get to you when I see them. And if you're interested in purchasing a challenger for your cleaning company, or if you're interested in starting a carpet cleaning company, I'd be happy to talk to you about challenger. The big discount is over now, but the $100 dealer rebate through me is still available. I'm the only person that does that. So if you're interested, you're welcome to text. It's 512-350-1129. Thanks for watching, guys, and God bless. I've got to go do some tile and some wood in the same house. So I guess I'm gonna cover probably both of those since I don't have hardly any wood videos. I got maybe three or four of those, and I've got maybe 25-30 tile videos. I do more carpet repair than anything else. Carpet cleaning comes in too, but you gotta start somewhere. So I started out being a carpet cleaner. Then you work into other stuff if you're interested, like Saltillo tile, travertine, strip and wax VCT tiles, Saltillo, if I said that, I don't know. Anyway, you kind of learn as you go, and as people ask for things, you know. Sometimes people will ask you for something, you know, they want something done that you don't really know how to do, but you can contact somebody and kind of figure it out. And then sometimes people ask you for something that is just so off the wall, you know, like, I don't know, I mean, they'll, they'll ask you for something obscure, like hook up my cable TV or something. It's nuts the amount of things you get asked. But yeah, anyway, thanks for watching, guys. God bless. See you on the next one.